My dear friends, my dear masters, and my dear gods, let us see today some of the aspects of spiritual science or a role of spirituality in the qualities of a leader or leadership. A country is led by a politician, as you know. A school is led by its principal. A house is led by the head of the family. Business houses are led by business leaders. On the similar way, wrongdoing is led by wrongdoers. A robber is leading a gang of robbers. A thief leads a gang of thieves. So, everywhere leading is going on. Society has no dearth of leaders. But, as you see, the society is full of unrest, violence, and sorrow. People fight among themselves. Countries are busy fighting each other. International wars are progressing. We are witnessing day in and day out. Why? What is the cause for this bad situation? If we check up the reasons, we can count on among thousands of reasons, we find a lack of wealth, we can say lack of equality, lack of love, lack of trust among ourselves, lack of cooperation, lack of togetherness, or probably desire of more of wealth, more of luxuries, name and fame and so on. So for prosperity, has it all to do anything with such decent qualities, with the leaders or leadership? If the answer is no, why is the leadership at all? We can remain in such a doldrum for all the time. We need a better society. We need a happy society, a harmonious one, a peaceful society. Hence, we should have a proper leadership to show the progress towards well-being, in fact. We may not call one a leader if he leads us to ruin. The term leader simply means a person leading others. This makes it imperative for a leader to know the contents of well-being. Well-being is the fruit of combination of material riches and spiritual riches. A leader must be aware of physical as well as spiritual insights to derive the best of them. Leader simply means a person leading others. The term leader simply means a person leading others. This meaning does not specify the type of leadership, good or bad. It does not point out values of life. There arises to identify the type of leader required. Mere a leader is not suffice. Proper leader is required for us. The efficacy of a leader boils down to achieving a healthy progress in whatever field they operate, with men and material, of course. Proper leadership is required to fix material progress and human progress in peace and tranquility. A leader has the two objects to achieve. One, to enhance physical progress. One, to enhance material progress, making a prosperous country. And on the other side, to achieve cooperative, harmonious existence, making a nation a peaceful nation. So thus, two goals are there for the leader. So to say, one, to achieve proper material progress, making a prosperous country, and on the other side, a cooperative, harmonious, and coexisting peaceful nation. Now, let us see the kind of leaders we have. Modern leaders are made up of modern education of physical sciences. Physical sciences deal in elements, which are panchabhutas. In Sanskrit we say prithivi, apaha, tejas, vayu, akasha, earth, water, fire, air and space, as you all know. All of these are matters, physical. So, we produce leaders in matters and material, and they are apparently leaders in dealing with matter, with objective knowledge, coupled with a deep sense of possessive and material progress. Any amount of material riches fail to make humans contented. Man never says he needs no more. There is a sense of frustration everywhere and for all the time. This frustration bounces back in the workplace. People find it tough to work with and face a lot of unrest, dislocating the progress in turn. Here, the leaders are stuck up. Why? We need spiritual knowledge, spiritual wisdom, which teaches us how to deal with men and material riches. But we are kept away from spiritual science in schools and colleges. Society is not essentially a matter or physical. It is spiritual as well. Humans are all spiritual. Hence, leaders in physical sciences may not do well without spiritual awareness. Management of material is not management of men. It must have some element of spiritual touch therein. They must have also subjective knowledge to manage the subjects. And here the spiritual science becomes the need of the hour. In fact, leaders in physical sciences must associate with spiritual aspects of the humans in order to read them, lead them. They may provide the physical needs such as food, clothing and shelter, commonly known as roti, kapda and makam, to people. But they lack the spiritual needs such as coexistence, loving, living together with harmony, equality, untouchability, non-violence, etc., etc. These are the ingredients of spiritual science. It is the science of oneness or getting together. Spiritual science explains that we are all connected by self or spirit or soul, named in the olden days as Atman. We are all spiritual and not physical bodies of bone, blood or flesh. Spirit is the core of spiritual science, which is omniscient, omnipresent, manifesting in all that is. Spiritual science defines a leader as a person not merely leading others, being in the front, but the one who dares not to be ahead of others, only to take care up to the last man of his group. The supreme quality of leadership is integrity and not authority. The function of leadership is to produce more leaders, not followers. Effective leadership is not about making speeches or being liked by others. Leadership is defined by results, not by attributes. The real leader has no need to lead. He is content to point the way. In the olden days in India, every ruler used to have one spiritual saint or rishi to guide in their governance of their provinces. Lord Sri Rama had Saint Vashistha as an advisor. King Bali had Shukracharya, and so on. A well-known philosopher of Athens in Greece, Socrates, did say that only spiritual leaders should rule the provinces of subjects. Such was the importance they attributed to spiritual wisdom. The leadership in modern times has taken a beat on the subjective perceptions and moving around the materialistic objective goals. More and more physicality prevail over the spiritual aspects. Mechanical and physical priorities rule over the wise, taking a beat again on the content of love, non-violence, etc. in the humanity, thus disrupting the peace in the society.